Hello and welcome to our meditation and our scriptural time. I am Perpetua Funke. Today we are going to be meditating from the book of Proverbs, the 8th chapter, beginning at the 12th verse. Proverbs 8, 12 to 21. I, wisdom, dwell together with prudence. I possess knowledge and discretion. To fear the Lord is to hate evil. I hate pride and arrogance, evil behavior and perverse speech. Counsel and sound judgment are mine. I have insight, I have power. By my kings I reign, and rulers issue decrees that are just. Rulers issue decrees that are just. By my princes I govern, and nobles who rule on the earth. I love those who love me, and those who seek me find me. With me are riches and honor, enduring wealth and prosperity. My fruit is better than fine gold. What I yield surpasses choice silver. I walk in the way of righteousness along the paths of justice, bestowing a rich inheritance to those who love me and making their treasures full. This is the word of the Lord. Dear brethren in Christ, wisdom is a very good attribute, and anyone considered wise feels good about it. When we feel good, we could be tempted to think that we have achieved the climax or we have arrived. And this could bring about some vices that wash down the wisdom. Our passage begins with some attributes to wisdom. Wisdom is prudent, knowledgeable, and discreet. Prudence, knowledge, and discretion. Now, these are very important words. Words that if we're used to describe you or me, we would lift up our chin and puff our chest and feel very good about ourselves. Yet, these words are pivotal in demonstrating to us the point that wisdom is not boastful. Wisdom, simply possessing prudence, knowledge, and discretion, doesn't guarantee us that life will be good or that our life will be pleasing to God. It is good to be prudent. It is good to have the ability to be careful, meticulous, methodological, and cautious in making decisions. It is good to possess knowledge. It means that we are smart, intellectually astute. We who are parents are encouraged to exercise parental discretion before we allow our kids to watch certain movies or television programs. To have discretion means that you have good judgment. You are careful and thoughtful before you decide. Wisdom is also combined with the fear of the Lord. Solomon said, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom." Are you aware of the majesty and might of the Almighty God? Does it affect the way you live, the way you interact with others, and the desires of your hearts? Does the fear of the Lord give you greater desire to walk in obedience with the Lord? Jesus spoke to the people of his day and said, "Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do what I say?" What we can say that we understand what it means to live with reverence and awe of God and His ways, and yet live like however we want to live. Our prayer today should be that God should give us divine wisdom, that we live according to the dictates of God, and that we use our wisdom with discretion, knowledge, and most of all, the fear of the Lord. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you because you have divinely placed in our lives those who speak the holy truth and those who love the words of wisdom. Give us, Lord, a heart of discernment to know when you are using someone to speak instruction into our hearts and our circumstances, and give us the strength and the courage to follow through what advice or even what is hard to follow. Fill us with peace in knowing that even when we take the wrong turn, your purpose will prevail. All this we ask in the precious name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. May God bless your day.